Hello everyone, today we are going to see the numerical on the basis of heat balance of the IC engine. In that, the first example, a two-stroke diesel engine was motored when the meter reading was 1.5 kW. Then the test on the engine was carried out on for the 1 hour and the following observations were recorded. Brake torque is 120 Newton, speed is the 600 RPM, fuel use is 2.5 kg, calorific value of the fuel is 40.3 megajoule per kg, cooling water use is 818 kg, rise in temperature of the cooling water is 10 degree centigrade, exhaust gas temperature is 345 degree centigrade and the room temperature is 25 degree centigrade and the air fuel ratio is 32:1. Okay, so these are the numerical. We have to find out brake power, indicated power, mechanical efficiency, indicated thermal efficiency, and draw the heat balance sheet on the minute basis and also in the percentage. So we have to calculate the draw the heat balance sheet in the minute basis and the percentage basis. Okay, first of all, we have to write down all the given data. Okay, so what is given? So this is the friction power is given. Okay, brake torque is T is given, speed N is given. Okay, now the fuel consumption, okay, is given, also given for the 1 hour. So 2.5 kg and this CV of fuel is given, calorific value, the weight of the water which is consumed during the test is 818 kg, rise in temperature is given, also delta T is given, 10 degree centigrade, 40 water, exhaust gas temperature is also given and the room temperature or the ambient temperature is also given. Okay, now we will see first one, brake power. So for the brake power, the equation is that, so 2 pi nt by 60, what is the equation? 2 pi nt is the equation. So 2 pi nt, we have to find out this into 40 minute basis. So 2 pi n is given, rpm is given, 600 RPM divided by 60 into 120, torque is also given divided by 1000. So we will get the brake power as 7.54 kilowatt. Now we have to find out the indicated power. So indicated power is the sum of the brake power and the friction power. So indicated power is equal to brake power plus the friction power. So we have find out the brake power is 7.54 plus 15 1.5, this is 1.5 kilowatt. So friction power is also given, so we have indicated power is 9.04 kilowatt. Okay, now the mechanical efficiency is given by, so mechanical efficiency is equal to output divided by input. So we will get here the output is our brake power divided by indicated power. So we have put the value of brake power. Brake power value is 7.54 and the value of indicated power is 9.04. So we will get the 0.834 is equal to 83.4%. The mechanical efficiency of the engine is 83.4%. Now we have to find out indicated thermal efficiency. So the equation for the indicated thermal efficiency is, so IP divided by CV, MF into CV. Okay, the equation is IP divided by mf into cv, where m is the mass of fuel supply and the cv is the calorific value of the fuel. So we have put down the value of integrated power is 9.04 divided by the value of mass of fuel is also given 2.5 per hour. So we will get the 2.5 divided by, we have to convert this into the 3600, okay, into calorific value. This value is going here. So we will get the integrated power as integrated thermal efficiency is 0.323 is equal to 32.3%. So we will get the integrated thermal efficiency is 32.3%. Okay. Now we will see the heat balance sheet. Okay. So first we have to find out heat balance. In heat balance sheet, first there are the four parameters. Okay, main four parameters of the heat balance sheet. First is the heat supplied. Second one is the heat utilized. Okay, so for heat supplied, we have mf into cv. Okay, so qs is equal to mf into cv. Okay, so qs is equal to mf into cv. So we will get the mf is given 2.5 kg per hour. So this is converted into the minute. So 2.5 divided by 60 into calorific value of the fuel is 40.3 megajoule per kg. So it is converted into 40,300 kilojoule per kg. So we will get the answer. Total heat supplied is given by 1680 kilojoule per minute. So QS is equal to 1680 kilojoule per minute. Okay. Now we have to find out energy supplied or heat utilized. Okay. So first there are the four criteria of this. The heat as a output means heat is in the break power. So QBP is equal to break power. So we have to find out this into the minute basis. So it is in the second. So 7.54 into 60. So we will get the 452.4 kilojoule per minute. So QBP is equal to 452.4 kilojoule minute. Now the heat carried away by the cooling water. Heat carried away by the cooling water. The equation for the heat carried away by the cooling water is mc into cp into T0 minus TI. Okay. So mass of cooling water is given. This is mass of cooling water. Specific heat of water is also given, 4.2. Okay. And the temperature difference is also given. Delta T is given. So T0 minus TI is also given. So it is 10. So we will get the heat carried away by the cooling water is 570.8 kilojoule per minute. So this is the QCW. This is QBP. Now heat carried away by the exhaust gas. Heat carried away by the exhaust gas. For that, QEG is equal to mg into cpg into delta T. Okay. So mass of gas, specific heat of gas, and the temperature difference means T out minus T in of the exhaust gas. This is the exhaust gas temperature and this is the room temperature. So difference of that is we have to take out. So mass of gas is given. So mass of gas is equal to mg is equal to mf plus ma. Mg is equal to mf plus ma. In this case, mass of fuel is given. Okay, this is mass of fuel is given, and the ma is also given, that air fuel ratio is given. Okay, so we have mass of air also. So put the value of this in the equation and we will get, this is mf, this is mg into specific heat of gas is 1.05 and the TO minus T1. So we will get the 462 kilojoule per minute. Now we have to find out uncounted heat losses, means whichever heat is not counted directly, it is the by calculated from the, this is the, is equal to heat supplied, means the equation is QS is equal to Q uncounted is equal to QS minus in the bracket QBP plus QCW plus Q exhaust gas. So we will get the energy supply is given 1680 minus in the bracket as a brake power into heat carried away by the cooling water and the heat carried away by the exhaust gas. So we will get the 197.8 kilojoule per minute. Now we have to find out it into the percentage basis. So we have to find out this into the percentage basis. So in the percentage basis, the heat supplied QS is equal to 100%. So this is the 100%. QS and Q utilized. Okay, so QS is the heat supplied is what is 1679, which is 100%, as we have the brake power Q, cooling water Q, exhaust gas and Q uncounted. Okay, so brake power is a, we have brake power there 452.4, like that cooling water is 462. Exhaust gas is also given 570, and this is 570.8. So we have to calculate into the percentage. To heat as a brake power is 20.94, heat in cooling water is 33.97, heat in exhaust gas is 27.51, and heat uncounted is 11.79. So this is the in the percentage basis, and this is in the, this is in the minute basis. Okay.